Our focus now is on the rhomboid fossa. We approach the rhomboid fossa in an isolated brainstem specimen with the cerebellum completely removed. There are several important reasons why one should be looking at the rhomboid fossa. The most important one is that the rhomboid fossa contains several grooves and elevations hinting at important internal structures both in the medulla and the pons. The rhomboid fossa has a diamond shape. There is an upper triangle of it overlying the pons and a lower triangle overlying the open portion of medulla oblongata. The division line between the two is an imaginary line run between the lateral recesses of the fourth ventricle, below which we enter the territory of the open medulla. You can also see these lines, the striae medullaries, also giving you an important hint as to where to find the division. The rhomboid fossa has a line in the middle dividing the brain into two halves. And then moving more laterally, the sulcus limitans is another longitudinal groove. In the caudal pontine area, there's an elevation bilaterally called the facial colliculus. The facial colliculus is fairly important because it is formed by internal structures. Specifically, fascicles of facial nerve are curving around, looping around the abducens nucleus. We can move caudally into the territory of the medulla oblongata and notice that the caudal end of rhomboid fossa is at the obex, this caudalmost point, below which the ventricular system transitions into the central canal. The central canal can only be seen from an internal view. Adjacent to obex is area postrema, one of our circumventricular organs, a chemosensitive area of the ventricular system. Medial to area postrema is the vagal trigone representing the site of dorsal motor nucleus of the vagus. Medial to vagal trigone is the hypoglossal trigone. Both of these are medial to sulcus limitans. Further rostrally and laterally in the open medulla is the vestibular area. Note that the vestibular area is lateral to sulcus limitans. To summarize, we have just seen surface features on the floor of the fourth ventricle, the rhomboid fossa, and these signify underlying internal structures. At the end, now, we move to the closed or caudal portion of the medulla to find these paired elevations called tubercles, the gracile, and more laterally, the cunate tubercles. These are terminations of the like-named fasciculi, the gracile and cunate fasciculi, ascending from the dorsal or posterior columns of the spinal cord.